Hello. I think we're good. Yeah, okay. So, we're doing fresh tomatoes into sauce today, all right? You guys saw in the other video, I got a bushel full of tomatoes from Long Island. First thing we're gonna do, wash the bad boys, all right? Just run them under water with your hands, stick them on a towel. They do not need to be 100% dry. All right, just lay them on a dish towel, and then we'll move on to step two. All right, I'll be right back. Okay, washed everybody, we're good. A couple yucky spots, couldn't give a shit less, we'll just cut them out. You need a big sauce pot for the amount that I've got. If you got less than that, use a smaller one. So, I'm gonna stick the sauce pot in the sink, okay? Make sure you got one of those little catcher things at the, you know, the strainers at the bottom of the sink. You know me, the aphasia, I can't think of the right word. The drainer things at the bottom. And take your rings off to catch yucky pieces of tomato. Get a good knife, not a huge one. That's a little big. Get a paring knife. This is good. Don't get a big one, get a huge one. We're not gonna use the cutting board for this. We're gonna do it in our hands, okay? So over the sauce pot, and prepare to get dirty. All right, so here's Mr. Plum Tomato. That's another thing I didn't go over. We're gonna use plum tomatoes. I do have a couple beefsteak tomatoes over there. I think I'm gonna throw those in because they look like if I don't use them by the end of today, they might start going a little yucky. I haven't decided yet, I'll take a look again. But for the most part, you're going to use plum tomatoes for sauce, the oval ones, all right? So, these do not need to be perfectly cut even. All you got to do is just cut pieces, okay? And they don't need to be exact, like that one's certainly not, okay? And throw it in. Try to cut small pieces, certainly cut the top yucky piece out. When you get the yucky piece, throw it in the sink. Okay, that's why that little drainage thingamabobby that I can't remember the word for is important. Because after we get enough of those suckers in the sink, we're gonna take a second and clean the sink out and then keep going, all right? So just, you know, make pieces like that into the sauce, all right? And bigger is fine. It does not have to be uniform, okay? And I'm gonna be doing this for a little while. I'll let you know when I'm done. The clock says it is 1:58, all right? So I've got a schlew, and I'll let you know when I'm done, okay? All right, it is 2:16. So it took almost 20 minutes. So it took 18 minutes for me to do the whole pot. And this pot is close to full. Let me just put the paring knife down. Ooh, son of a bitch. All right, hang on, let me show it to you. All right, this sucker's pretty good and full. So, I'm going to, now this has really nothing in it except literally tomatoes. This is a 1/3 cup. Oop. 1/3 cup of water. Alright. I've got some cold water running in my sink. 1/3 cup of water will do. Now while I'm cutting it, all the juices of the tomato and all the goo in between the seeds are coming out into the bottom of the pan. I just added 1/3 cup of water, and that's all I'm adding. All right? That is literally enough to get it to go. I'm gonna stick it. Holy shit. That's a lot. I'm gonna stick it on the burner, and I'm gonna stick it on medium low. All right, and we're just gonna walk away from it. It's gonna be cooking for a while. All right? I'll let you know what the time is because I honestly, God, don't know. It's based on what I see. All right? And I'll show you what I'm talking about once it's done. I'm going to clean up the sink. And then I got a lot. You know what? Let me run this down. Hold on. Okay. So in the last video, I got Lydia Bistianich on the TV. I love her. She's amazing. Okay. So in my last video, I asked for, what do you guys want? This is what I got. You guys wanted me to do the tomatoes. I got a couple requests for actually the pork skin brujoles. I'm amazed. So I'm going to do pork skins. I'm going to do that right now. I got a couple low-carb meal ideas. I'll do that soon. I got a request for risotto. I'll do that. I got a request for an eggplant dish other than eggplant parm. I don't use eggplant other than in an eggplant parm-like setting. All right? The only other way I use eggplant other than in parm is if I bread it, fry it, and I'll lay it on top of like a veal cutlet, smother that in cheese, and then like a sauce goes on top of that. It's called Sorrentino. It's divine. But that's really the only way I use eggplant. I don't make homemade campanada, and campanada is made with eggplant. I don't make that homemade. I use a brand called Cuculo, and that's amazing. So that's really the only thing I do with eggplant. Yeah, those were like my main requests so far. So keep the requests coming. Let me clean up my mess, and we'll start doing pork skin brujol. All right, hold on. Pig skin time. So I got a pile of the crap I need over here. Yeah. So first thing you want to do, and please excuse my kitchen, it's an absolute mess. It's because I got to do the recipe making sauce after you and I get off the camera. After we keep bullshitting. So I'm gearing up for that. And I do have that, I do have the other steps of making sauce on video already. I'll put the links in the bottom bar to that. And so you can just, you know, make the bottom bar thingamajiggy. Come down, see how I make sauce, see how I make meatballs. And yeah. The other things I put in sauce are, I use beef brujol. They also make pork brujol, which is made out of pork loin, and pork skin brujol. All right? So let's do pork skin. If you do not have a Italian market near you where they have pork skin available, I learned a trick. Go to a Mexican market. Because what do Mexicans enjoy pork skin for? Chicharrones. And they love pork skin. So that was a trick I learned. And it was a wonderful trick. Because now I don't got to schlep to Staten Island to get myself some piggy skin. All right? So here we go. Here's some pig skin. All right? We're going to wash it. Give it a quick rinse. Cold water. Lay down towel, lay down paper towel on a piece of our clean countertop. All right, just give it a quick rinse. All right, we're good. And you never know what shape these suckers are gonna be in. The ones in Italian markets are usually shaped like a long rectangle because the Guineas know what you're going to do with them. We're using them for brujols. But in Mexican markets, that's usually not what they're used for. So they don't need to make them in long rectangles. It's not necessary. So yeah. Just pat it dry. And now we can move on. Never. Okie dokie. So I'm going to just lay this bad boy down, and I'll move the camera. Give me one sec. I got to wash my hands. Don't ask me why I'm doing it, because as soon as I wash my hands, I'm going to be touching pigskin again. So why the hell am I even bothering, Jean? I don't know. It doesn't make sense. But I'm doing it. I'm starving. I'm really fucking starving. As soon as I'm done making the brujol, I gotta find something to eat. I'm fucking starving. Holy shit. Maybe my sugar's dropping or something. I don't know. Alright. Hang on a sec. Alright. Let me push it in. Okay. So, Mr. Piggy Skin, first thing you do, look for imperfections. Sometimes you can find nipples on these. I'm not kidding. You really can. All right? So take a look if you've got any, because if you do, you're going to want to cut them off. All right? Just do a little heavy-duty shaving on it if you need to get the nippies off. I don't see anything scary. I think we're good. Yep, okay. So, next, flip it over. Okay, skin side goes down, mushy side faces me. All right, now, this is kind of a weird shape. All right, so you can trim this if you want to, which I'm going to do. Or you can just make a humongo one if you want to. Alright, that's up to you. This sucker, if I left it alone, would end up this long. That's huge. Okay, that's humongo. I don't know if I want it that long, because that would really be humongo. I'm thinking about doing a quick trim job. I think I might. So give me a sec. And I'm just not using a sharper knife because I don't want to make more dishes because I'm psycho. Give me a sec. Yeah, that would be good. Okay. Beautiful. All right, this guy, kid you not, I'm gonna bake it. And holy shit, is that gonna be good. Oh, holy shit, is that gonna be good. That is the crackling on a fresh ham right there. Holy shit. Okay. So, oh, let me get cheese. All right, so five ingredients go in a pork skin brujol. Hang on. All right. The one ingredient, that you put the most of in is Romano cheese. All right. You can use Parmesan if you want to. But Parmesan is the weaker of the two cheeses that are prominently used in, like, you know, pasta and shit like that. So, you know, you can use that if you want to, but I prefer Romano because, you know, I got a set of balls. All right, moving on. So, salt, pepper, garlic powder, parsley, and lots of cheese, all right? And I am actually going to use a little smidge of onion powder in there, just because I like onions. There you go. So here we go. First one is going to be black pepper. This is actually a pepper mill. This sucker's neato. Now, as far as measurements are concerned, how much am I putting on of each one? I have no fucking clue. I cannot give you measurements. I can't give you measurements because I have no idea how big of a piece of pork skin you're going to get. Okay? I have no idea. That's completely going to depend on the ratio that is based off of the size of pork skin you get, not fungal, the size of pork skin you get, and the amount of seasoning you're going to use based on the size of the pork skin you get. So I really can't answer that. I wish I could, I can't. So, you know, guesstimate, okay? A little bit of salt. I like using this thing. Hold on, can you see it? Yeah. I like using this thing so that I don't keep sticking my dirty fingers in the salt container. And even though I know finger germs, the majority of finger germs get killed in salt containers like that, I would prefer to not stick my dirty fingers in the salt container. Next. Now, let me use the little shaky side. Where's this? There you go. Little bit of garlic. Excuse me, this is onion. Little bit of onion. Not going to go crazy on the... Oh, we clogged. Not going to go crazy on the onion. Okay. Now, what I'm doing right now, I will be rubbing around and making it all even. Okay? This is garlic. Believe it or not, don't go crazy on the garlic. And you know what's crazy too? None of this is like fresh. This isn't fresh ingredients. You don't want fresh in the pork skin brajol because when you cook it, everything is gonna fall out. All right? When I cook this son of a bitch, it's all gonna fall out if I make it fresh. It's gonna seep out the sides. It's gonna seep out the sides because I am going to be using a lot of cheese on this SOB. So the cheese, the fat in the cheese, is going to suck up all the seasoning I used and be a vehicle to let it run out the sides. You with me? So you really can't use, it's best if you don't use fresh on these suckers. If you want the seasoning you use to stay inside. And, you know, my family figured that out through trial and error. I'm sure a shitload of chefs, particularly Gordon Ramsay, would be like, what the fuck is she saying? But it's true. So, yeah. I'm just trying to even out the seasoning. All right, I got everything on there except the cheese. This is my cheese container. Okay. You start with that. And I can tell I need more than that. All right, that looks like at least a quarter cup of cheese, at least. And you don't, when you do the cheese, leave like an inch lip off of this. When we roll this sucker, I'm going to start over here and roll, and this is going to be the end. Don't put cheese right here for an inch. All right? Leave that alone. Otherwise, you're going to have cheese coming out that side like crazy. Okay? Especially when you cook it. So just leave it alone. And you can definitely leave an edge over here with no cheese. Because, I mean, it's cheese. It's going to melt. Even though it's Romano, it's going to melt. So, trust me, it'll get on the edges when you're cooking it. So just pack the cheese in. Move it around and pack it down. Honestly, I think I could use a little more cheese. All right. There we go. Just do a little scoop on the cheese and try to get it distributed right. Once you got it everywhere you want it, push down on it and, you know, pack it. And you should be alright with it not going everywhere. Alright. Last step. We gotta roll this son of a bitch. Ready? Okay. Just do a quick rinse of my hands. Alright. We gotta roll and tie. You are gonna need some cooking twine. Alright, you can always find them in the baking aisle. They look like that. Am I getting it in there? Yeah. They look like that. Alright. There is a way for you to, what the fuck this is? Oh, it's right there. There is a way for you to cut this sucker off in the plastic container, but I can't stand doing that. So I always use scissors. Alright. So you're going to take this guy and you're going to start rolling them up. You don't want to do too tight, otherwise you're going to push all the cheese forward and none of it's going to stay in place. Alright. And we should be good. And press down. Okay. We're good. Alright. Now, I'm going to sneak some string under. I can see this end is giving me a hard time. So let me put some string under that end first. All right. And you're always gonna have one end, when it's like this, and it's not from an Italian store that, you know, did it very cookie cuttery, you're always gonna have one end fatter than the other. So don't worry about it. Okay, don't worry about it. Son of a bitch. Alright, I'm gonna have to lasso this sucker 3 times. Like the way you used to have to tie your shoes when you were in kindergarten. There we go. There we go. Alright. I really need thicker twine, to be honest with you. I gotta do that. Alexa, remind me to buy thick twine on Amazon.
When should I remind you?
4 o'clock.
Okay, I'll remind you at 4 p.m.
Alright, so I made one little tie, but I can still see the sucker's opening at the end. So let me get one more down here. Because all this cheese and yumminess is gonna fall out. Let me do another. All right. There we go. Now we're cooking with gas. Okay. All right, we're good. So, you sneak these underneath. And you do the whole thing. Magic. Alright. I'm going to get this done, and I'll try to speed it up on the video editor. And I'll start bullshitting with you when I'm done, right? We are good. Okay, we're good. That is how you make a pork skin brujol. So what I'm gonna do now, because I'm not ready to cook it yet, I gotta still work on the tomatoes, I am going to wrap this in saran wrap and stick it in the fridge. Once I get the tomatoes ready, and I still have to put them through a food mill, I'll take that, and I'm ready to start doing sauce, this gets cooked first. This is going to render out a lot of pork lard. Pork lard is such a vital necessity to good Italian sauce, all right? It's just, oh God, I gotta put on the oven. I gotta cook my, I gotta cook my fat. So pork lard is such a vital necessity to good sauce. It really is. It adds something nothing else can add. If you can't, in any way, shape, or form, get a pork skin brujol, then see if you can find pork lard, okay? I know the vast majority of you guys cannot get to a store called Pastosa. Pastosa is a New York and Jersey thing. In fact, there's only one in Jersey. And I think there's maybe five in New York, and that's it. All right? And the ones in New York are only on Staten Island and Long Island, and that's it. Nobody else has them. You can't get them. You can't get them in Manhattan. I don't think there's one in Queens. There's one in Brooklyn. The rest are on Long Island. And I think there's three on Staten Island? I don't remember. But if you can't get that, then try to find pork lard. All right, it is solid. It should be kept in the fridge. And it's just the most divine thing you've ever had in your life. So see what you can do. Otherwise, your third choice should be olive oil. All right, use olive oil. Yeah. So, still working on the tomatoes. Let me take a look at them. I hear them, but the ones on top doing nothing. So don't worry about it. So we're just gonna leave them and they'll do what they gotta do. All right? I will continue once the tomatoes are good. All right. It is 5:30. The tomatoes have been on since 2:16, something like that. I'm gonna give you a look at them. I don't know if you can see that because there's a lot of steam coming off them. But basically, they kind of turned into a boil. They were on medium well. And they cooked down enough, and they just started boiling like crazy. You're going to leave the pot alone. It's got to cool down enough so that you can actually stick your fingers in them. All right, so that's got a hell of a lot of time to go. I'm just going to push them off to the back burner and let them sit. I don't know if I can get to that today because I don't know how long that huge pot of tomatoes is going to take to cool down. But that's got to go through a food mill. So I don't know if I can do that today or tomorrow. That's up to the tomatoes. But once we get there, I'll let you know. Good morning. I'm so fucking tired. It's ridiculous. So I just want to show you real quick, last step of doing the tomatoes. This is a food mill. This is 3.5 ounces. It's not ounces, 3.5 quarts. Okay, this is what the big guy looks like. These are actually pretty cheap, okay? You wanna get yourself a real tall pot after you do the tomatoes. Because this guy, see how it's got the thingies on the side? It hangs in there, okay? Hook it up to the sides of the pot. Oh, holy shit. I'm gonna tilt you down so you can see in the pot, okay? Whoop. There we go. All right, I'm gonna get a spoon. Yeah, this guy's good. Where's the metal one? Here we go. Here we go. All right. So, first thing, you're gonna grab some tomatoes. All right, then you got quite a bit of juice. So you're just gonna grab a spoon of tomatoes, drop it in, okay? Now all I've got here is tomatoes and I think it was 1/3 cup of water that we stuck in there. What I'm doing before I stick the tomatoes in the mill, I am making the liquid of the tomatoes. Like I'm taking the spoonful of tomatoes and I'm leaning it on the side of the pot so that all the liquid from the tomatoes in this pot drains out, because I don't need the liquid. I just want to use the meat of the tomatoes, all right? And then, let me scoot this so I can hold the handle. Hang on. Hang on. There we go. All right? And then you're just gonna move it in clockwise. All right? Oh. I gotta get this done faster. Not a fast process. I'm warning you. All right. So this shit is gonna go up the sides. That's okay. Just scoot it back down again, all right? The tomato meat is gonna go, fucking hell, man. Tomato meat's gonna go back down the sides. Move it counterclockwise and it'll scoop back down. All right. Now, what you want is for you to run out of shit to grind. All right. When you make, let me catch you up here. Point is, I'm running out of battery, number one. Number two, I got somewhere to go in 5 minutes, so I'm like rushing you. Once you run out of tomato shit to pour down and the mush in the mill is like that, you can't get anything more out of that sucker, take the mush and stick it in a bowl and move on to another batch. Once you've got all that mush, the leftover mush in the bowl, stick that mush back in the food mill, grind it one more time. All right, when it's gone through its second grind, then throw it out. All right. What you're throwing out is the seeds and the skin, okay, the tough skins. The skinny skins, super tender skins, will make it through the grinder, all right? And the tough skins are going to get stuck in there. So that's how we do tomato. I got to charge this battery and get the fuck out of here. I'll be back. I didn't go over this. I forgot about it this morning. I was like such in a rush this morning. I just need to get the fuck out of the house. So I'm down to the end of my tomatoes. I was spooning them out, okay, and kind of draining a little bit of the water out every time I spooned it, and I wasn't taking the water with me to put into the food mill. All right, so I'm down to the end. I think I got most of the chunks out, but what I did is I used a small strainer, all right, over the sink. And I poured the water through the strainer. All the pieces went into the strainer with the water. The water is going to come out the bottom, all right? It's going to clog. You gotta stick a finger in there and scrape the bottom of the strainer because the seeds are gonna get in the way. So you gotta do it in a couple phases. And once you get a strainer full of stuff, dump that into the food mill until your pot's empty, and then you've got a pot full of sauce. All right, so yeah, do that. I don't know if I went over this either, but when you get all the schmutz that doesn't go through the food mill, all right, you're gonna scoop it out and keep it in a bowl. We're gonna do that one again. So here's my bowl of schmutz. That's going through the food mill one more time to see if I can get anything out of it. Once I do one more time, I'm gonna throw that schmutz out, all right? All right, number one, I've got Sinatra on in the background. I've got Pandora's Italian cooking music. Suck it up. Number two, my hair looks like a fucking rat's nest. You don't like it, click off. I got shit to do. And I'm making sauce. What better is there to put on except Sinatra? So I did the sauce. You're gonna shit yourself, it doesn't look like much. I have, hang on. I have a little bit of sauce left from the last time I did this with a different batch of, oh fuck, I forgot to do this one. I have a little bit of sauce left from the last time I did a batch of tomatoes. So I'm gonna whip that batch out the freezer and add it to this batch. All right? And hopefully that'll do it. If it does not, if I gotta whip out a can of Cento, so be it. You know, do what I gotta do. You will also need tomato paste. All right, because this sauce is a lot more watery than you're going to be used to if you use canned tomatoes. All right, this little section is just to show you how to do the pork skin brisket. Like I said, in the bottom bar, I'll put the video on how to make sauce and how to make meatballs. I'm going to show you how I cook the pork skin brisket. When you're cooking sauce, you've always got to start with the fattiest meats first and work your way to the leanest meats. You want to render the most fat you can out of all the meats you're going to use in the sauce. All right? So I'm not using sausages this time, which is a rarity for me. I always use sausage, but I'm not. So let's say you're doing pork skin brisket. I got beef brisoles, let's say I use sausage, and I got meatballs. Meatballs you always do in a separate pan, but I've got them already cooked and those are in there. You do the pork skin brisket first, all right? Then you do the sausage, because the sausage is the next to fattiest. Then you do the beef brisket, and you're good with cooking in the pan. You use the same olive oil on all three of those meats. All right, flavors are gonna melt, okay? And you yank them all out of the pan, keep that olive oil in there. And then you start working in that olive oil with, you know, your onions, your garlic, etc. All right? So here is my Mondo pork skin. That thing is pretty creepy. So let me throw you into the pan. Hang on a second. Ah, fuck. Ah, wait a minute. Make sure you can see. Now you can kind of see. All right. Believe it or not, I'm gonna put quite a bit in here. All right, I'm putting quite a bit because it takes some time to get pork skin to melt. I'm also gonna turn the heat down to medium. Excuse me, to medium low. All right, here's Mr. Porkskin. Get your lid ready, drop, cover. All right, and wear an apron. That son of a bitch is gonna kick grease up at you the whole time it's in there and have long gachi hooks. Well, you guys call them tongs. We call them gachi hooks in my family. Have long ones, all right? Don't get your hand close to that. You're gonna burn yourself. I'll be back. This song it's Frank Sinatra, Strangers in the Night. My grandfather used to sing this at my grandmother constantly. Skin brisket is done. I just shut it off. I flipped it a bunch of times, tried to get every side I could. Hang on. A warm, bracing dance away. I'm just It's time.
I'll show you what it looks like. I tried to get every side I could cooked, all right? I'm not crying because I'm sad, I'm crying because it's so beautiful. If you knew how romantic, my grandfather was toward my grandmother. But my grandfather was a douche to so many people. Like, he was just typical tough, you know, tough guy, Italian, don't mess with me kind of guy to so many people. But to my grandmother, he just melted, you know? Anyway, so I shut the pan off because it was really hot and all I had in there was olive oil. All right? I still got the olive oil in there. I'm not taking it out. I am going to do a little quick check on how much I've got in there. Because I've rendered the fat off the skin. Don't have that much, honestly. I don't have that much. I think because I cooked the skin so fast, it didn't really render, it just crisped. So this is a container of pork lard. I get it at Pastosa, okay, which is an Italian store. I'm gonna take a little bit of pork lard. Okay. Try to get a little more. There we go. I wanna try to get a little more juice in the bottom. And then now I'm gonna do the rest. All right? That's how you cook pork skin rissole. Now that it's done, once I get everything else going and I get my pot of sauce going, after the foamies go away, you watch the sauce video and know what I'm talking about when I say foamies. After the foamies come up and it's time to put in the meat, that sucker goes in. Now the longer that sucker goes in there, the better it's gonna be. It's magic, okay? That's how you do it. I love you guys. I hope you enjoy it. I promise you about 85-90% of you will think it's the most disgusting thing you've ever stuffed in your face in your life. But it's 100% peasant food and I crave it. It's divine. My father and I fight over it. Okay? I love you. Bye.